Hi friends, welcome to free online tech videos. My name is Ravi. In this video session we are going to see about ifconfig command. So the ifconfig command is mostly used on previous versions of RCL 5 and RCL 6 or CentOS 5 and CentOS 6, but in a new version of RCL 7, actually the command ifconfig is deprecated, but still they have a backend library support on this version, because if the user is switched immediately to the new version, maybe they are not going to adapt that fast. So that's why they given the support. You can still run ifconfig command on the RCL 7, but you have to install the support libraries or the ifconfig command on the RCL 7. So ifconfig is used to configure the kernel resident network interfaces. So it is used at boot time to set up interfaces as necessary, which means that if you type just ifconfig command over here, so what happens? So the if command will show you all the interfaces and their details. So what is this currently IP address of our ENS33, and that IP address and network mask and broadcast IP address and MAC address details. So this is the IP version 6 IP address, and this is the Ethernet MAC address. So the Ethernet MAC address, and you can see that how much, what is the type of that, is it Ethernet, or is it a different type of device like FC device or something else. Okay, so that's why it shows that type of that Ethernet, and how many packets are the, how many bytes are in the frame as received or errors or dropped, all the details. Like whenever if you type something like the network interface ping, or if you send any packets, so then how many is sent, how many is dropped, or all the details will be shown over here. Okay, and this line will be like Ethernet details. So what is our Ethernet details and what is your MTU details, all this stuff. So this is our loopback adapter details, what is the IP address of loopback and all the details. And you can also see that there is a Docker container installed in this machine, so that Docker 0 interface details also. Okay, let's see this. So how ifconfig can be used for us to in a regular basis to see that. Okay, ifconfig, if you type -a, it will show you the all the interfaces details, including every interface details, which is in down or up, whatever it is. If you can type ifconfig the interface name, particular interface name, it will show only that particular interface name only, in the sense that particular interface details only. So you can also bring up and bring down the interfaces using this. Suppose say ifconfig, if I say Docker 0, so there is an interface called Docker 0. So what I'm doing is that I'm bringing down that interface. So it says that operation not permitted because I'm not into the root. So if I'm not root user, then I cannot bring down any devices. Okay, so now I switch back to the root user and bring down the device. So now let's see that ifconfig Docker 0. So what happens? So the device is not, maybe you can see that ifconfig Docker 0, still it will show the same details, because but you can see that there is no bytes. So all the bytes are 0 because the device is down, so you cannot send and receive any details over here. So if you bring up this interface, ifconfig and say Docker 0 up, so that the device can be up and it will show you the all the details. And if you see sometimes the details of packets and bytes will be increased. So like that you can set some IP information using the ifconfig, also something like ifconfig, and provide your IP address, new IP address. Example, say 192.168.2.254, something like this. I would like to set some IP address to this machine, and you can also set netmask. Okay, what is your netmask details? You can give over here, and you can also say broadcast details. Okay, 192.168.2.255. So my broadcast details is this. You can give your broadcast details, and so like this you can also set MTU details. So the network interface packet pipeline details, so that you can how much MTU you can set, whether 1000, or if it is a more than a 1 Gbps line, you can set up 1500, something like that, based on your interface stuff. So like this you can use. So but whatever this configuration you are going to give now, so it's going to set the IP address temporary purpose. In the sense, if you reboot this IP system, then the IP will go off. So it is only the temporary configuration if you give ifconfig and IP address, netmask, and broadcast details and MTU details. This is set only until the temporary time. This is not a permanent base, because this is not going to write any configuration file over here. So what it will do, it just only set the information on the cache. So whenever you reboot, the cache will be cleared, and you do not have any IP address after that. So that is about the if configuration command. So you can also do something like disabling your Ethernet configuration and enabling the Ethernet configuration using the permissive configuration. Okay, so I say that is not recommended, or I'm not showing that details, because so if you do any of other machines, so the network interface will go off. So until unless you have the physical connectivity to that machine, you cannot bring up the interface. So but you can also change the MAC address of the interface using this ifconfig configuration. So let's say ifconfig example, say ENS something over, and show your hardware details, and if it is Ethernet, say Ether, and provide the new MAC address details over here. So I'm not providing any new MAC address over here. I'm going to type this the same MAC address over here for the Docker 0 and hardware Ether, and provide your MAC address. So what happens, this the new MAC address will be changed. So but most of the physical hardware will have their own MAC address, and the MAC address would be unique. So you no need to change any MAC address on the physical interfaces. But if you have example like virtual interfaces, like on the VMware, or if you are using VirtualBox, if you want to change your MAC address on this way, you can do that too. Okay, that's about the ifconfig command. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.